William Shakespeare, the myriad-minded dramatic genius of the Renaissance era, has been hailed as a man capable of portraying the vividness of human life with precision. His tragic heroes have mesmerized the audience worldwide with their aesthetic qualities, philosophies of life, and zealousness of nature, which are often entangled with their hamartia. The Cyrillian English Theatre of the PG Department of English proudly and humbly performs before you the psychologically and emotionally entangling play, Macbeth, The Man with Vaulting Ambition.
The English are coming. The English are coming. Here, let them lie till hunger forever consumes them. We might have met them direful, face to face, and beat them backward home in England. I have almost forgot the taste of fears. Now, horror, which is familiar to my mother's thoughts, does not affect me.
It's time to end the game, Macbeth.
I'll fight to the end. I'll put my shield and battle you. Come on, let's go at it, Macduff.
Yes, there was a time when his senses shivered hearing a sudden cry. His crop of hair arose with sudden fear, but not anymore. He had subdued all his fears. His life changed with the tumult because of them. They made fear disappear from his life. They made him treacherous. They made him ill-fed. They made him wretched. They made him ambitious.
Again, in thunder, lightning, or in rain?
When the holy burly is done, when the battle is lost and won.
That will happen before sunset.
Where should we meet?
Upon the heath.
There to meet with Macbeth.
I come, Grey Malkin.
Better calls.
I will be right here.
Fair is foul and foul is fair. Over through the fog and filthy air.
A drum! A drum! Macbeth has come!
The weird sisters, hand in hand, post us off the sea and land, thus to go about, about. Peace, the charms wound up.
So foul and fair a day I have not seen. I thought they will make us sweat a lot.
Your sword made it easy. How far is it supposed to be to Forest?
What are these creatures? They are so withered looking and crazily dressed. They don't look like they belong on this planet, but I see them standing here on Earth.
Are you alive? Speak if you can. What kind of creatures are you?
All hail, Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Glamis!
All hail, Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Carter!
All hail, Macbeth, the future king!
My dear Macbeth, why do you look so startled and afraid of these nice things they're saying? But you don't say anything to me. If you can see the future and say how things will turn out, tell me. I don't want your favors, and I'm not afraid of your hatred.
You are lesser than Macbeth, but also greater.
Not so happy, yet much happier.
Your descendants will be kings, even though you will not be one. So all hail Macbeth and Banquo.
My great and plentiful joys hide themselves in tears. Sons, relatives, chiefs, who are by virtue of this position nearest to me, let me inform you all that I am going to appoint Macbeth as the Thane of Cawdor and my eldest son Maccom as heir to my kingdom, who will be known as the Prince of Cumberland. It is celebration time for the people.
I, the Thane of Cawdor? Malcolm, the Prince of Cumberland? I, the Thane of Cawdor? Malcolm, the Prince of Cumberland?
You are Thane of Glamis in Cawdor, and you're going to be king just like you were promised. But I worry about whether or not you have what it takes to seize the crown. You are too full of the milk of human kindness to strike aggressively at your first opportunity. You want to be powerful, and you don't lack ambition. But you don't have the mean streak that these things call for. The things you want to do like a good man. You don't want to cheat. Yet you want what doesn't belong to you. There's something you want, but you're afraid to do what you need to do to get it. You want it to be done for you. Hurry home so I can persuade you and talk you out of whatever's keeping you from going after the crown. After all, fate and witchcraft both seem to want you to be king.
The king is coming here tonight.
You must be crazy to say that. Isn't Macbeth with the king? And wouldn't Macbeth have told me in advance so I could prepare if the king were really coming?
I'm sorry, but it's the truth. Macbeth is coming. He sent a messenger ahead of him who arrived here, so I've read that he could barely speak his message.
Take good care of him. He brings great news. You spirits that assist murderous thoughts, make me less like a woman and more like a man, and fill me from head to toe with deadly cruelty. Thicken my blood and clog up my veins so I won't feel remorse, so that no human compassion can stop my evil plan or prevent me from accomplishing it. Come to my female breast and turn my mother's milk into poisonous acid. You murdering demons, wherever you hide, invisible and waiting to do evil. Come, thick night, and cover the world in the darkest smoke of hell, so that my sharp knife can't see the wound it cuts open, and so heaven can't peep through the darkness.
My dearest love, Duncan is coming here tonight.
And when is he leaving?
He plans to leave tomorrow.
That day will never come. Your face betrays strange feelings, my lord, and people will be able to read it like a book. In order to deceive them, you must appear the way they expect you to look. Let me handle tonight's preparations, because tonight will change every night and day for the rest of our lives.
This castle isn't a pleasant place. The air is sweet and appeals to my refined senses. Look, here comes our honored hostess. The love of my subjects often bring me inconvenience, but I still accept it as love. In doing so, I am teaching you to thank me for the inconvenience I'm causing you by being here, because it comes from my love to you.
Everything we are doing for you, even if it doubled and then doubled again, is nothing compared to the honors you have brought to our family. We gladly welcome you as our guest with gratitude for both the honors you've given us before and the new honors you've just given us.
Where is Macbeth? The Thane of Cawdor and his great love, fair and noble hostess, we are your guests tonight.
In crimes like these, there are still punishments in this world. By committing violent crimes, we only teach other people to commit violence. And the violence of our students will come back to plague us teachers. The king trusts me in two ways. First of all, I am his kinsman and his subject, so I should always try to protect him. Second, I am his host, so I should be closing the door in his murderer's face, not trying to murder him myself. Besides, Dungan has been such a humble leader, so free of corruption, that his virtuous legacy will speak for him when he dies. The only thing motivating me is ambition, which makes people rush ahead of themselves towards disaster. We can't go on with this plan. The king has just honored me, and I have earned this good opinion of all sort of people. I want to enjoy these honors while the feeling is fresh and not throw them away so soon.
Were you drunk when you seemed so hopeful before? Have you gone to sleep and woken up green and pale in fear of this idea? From now on, this is what I'll think of your love. Are you afraid to act the way you desire? Will you take the crown you want so badly, or will you live as a coward, always saying, "I can't," after you say, "I want to"? You're like the poor cat in the old story who wanted to eat fish but was afraid of wetting its feet.
Please, stop. I dare to do only what is proper for a man to do. He who dares to do more is not a man at all.
If you weren't a man, then what kind of animal were you when you first told me you wanted to do this? The time and place weren't right before, but you'd have gone ahead with the murder anyhow. Now the time and place are just right, but they're almost too good for you. If I were to suckle a baby and I knew how sweet it is to love it at my breast, but even as the baby was smiling up at me, I would have plucked my nipple out of its mouth and smashed its brain out against a wall if I had sworn to do that the same way you have sworn to do this.
But if we fail?
We? Fail? If you get your courage up, we can't fail. When Duncan is asleep, the day's hard journey has definitely made him tired. I'll get his two servants so drunk that their memory will go up in smoke through the chimneys of their brains. When they lie asleep like pigs, so drunk, they'll be dead to the world. And what won't you and I be able to do to the unguarded Duncan? And whatever we do, we can lay all the blame on the drunken servants.
May you only give birth to male children, because your fearless spirit should create nothing that isn't masculine. Once we have covered the two servants with blood and used the daggers to kill, won't people believe that they were the culprits?
Who could think it happened any other way? We'll be grieving loudly when we hear that Duncan has died.
Now I'm decided, and I will exert every muscle in my body to commit this crime. Go now and pretend to be a friendly hostess. Hide with the false pleasant face what you know in your false evil heart.
Who is there?
A friend.
You are not asleep yet, sir? The king is in bed. He has been in an unusually good mood and has granted many gifts to your household and servants.
Because we were unprepared for the king's visit, we weren't able to entertain him as well as we would wanted to.
Everything's okay. I had a dream last night about the three witches. At least part of what they said about you was true.
I don't think about them now. But when we have an hour to spare, we can talk more about it, if you're willing.
Anytime.
This is the dagger I see in front of me, with its handle pointing towards my hand. Come, let me hold you. I don't have you, but I can still see you. Fateful apparition, isn't it possible to touch you as well as see you? Oh, are you nothing more than a dagger created by the mind, a hallucination from my fevered brain? You are leading me toward the place I was going already. I never was planning to use a weapon just like you. There is no dagger here. It's a murder I am about to do. Now, half the world is asleep and being deceived by evil nightmares. Witches are offering sacrifices to their goddess Hecate. I'm going now. The murder is as good as done. The bell is telling me to do it. Don't listen to the bell, Duncan. Because it summons you either to heaven or to hell. I have done the deed. I killed him. I killed King Duncan. The voice kept crying, "Sleep no more," to everyone in the house. Macbeth has murdered sleep, and therefore Macbeth will sleep no more.
Who said that? Why, my worthy lord, you let yourself become weak when you think about things in this cowardly way. Go get some water and wash this bloody evidence from your hands. Why did you carry this dagger out of the room? They have to stay there. Go take them back and smear the sleeping guards with the blood.
I can't go back. I'm afraid even to think about what I have done. I have killed King Duncan. I can't stand to look at it again.
Coward, give me the dagger. Dead and sleeping people can't hurt you any more than pictures can. Only children are afraid of scary pictures. If Duncan bleeds, I'll paint the servants' faces with his blood. We must make it seem like they are guilty.
Where is that knocking coming from? What's happening to me? That I am frightened of every noise? Will all the water in the ocean wash this blood from my hands?
My hands are as red as yours, but I would be ashamed if my heart were as pale and weak. I hear someone knocking at the south entry. Let's go back to our bedroom. A little water will wash away the evidence of our guilt. It's so simple. You've lost your soul. Listen, there's more knocking. Put on your nightgown in case someone comes and sees that we're awake. Snap out of your daze.
Good morning.
Is the king awake? What he thane?
Not yet.
He commanded me to wake him up early. I have almost missed the time he requested. I will wake him.
because that's my job.
Oh, horror! 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 The mind cannot conceive, nor the tongue utter such horror. Destruction could not have taken a greater evil. Brutal murder has broken up the sacred body of anointed king. Oh, King Duncan is no more. King Duncan is no more.
Oh, you bloody souls. You have killed our king with your knives. Yes, the blood stains. It's crystal clear. I won't spare you for a moment. Macbeth's sword will answer you.
The ambition of being a king, a ruler, rolls him into such an extent that he kills his own honorable King Duncan, who believed him blindly and showered honors upon him. His ambitions and his lady, they didn't allow his due respect reach the king. He deceived him, he murdered him with all treacherous, with all wretched mind. He deceived his own country. Macbeth had become a cruel warrior, a cruel human being.
Hail King Macbeth! Hail the king!
You are lesser than Macbeth, but also greater.
Not so happy, yet much happier.
Your descendants will be kings, even though you will not be one. So all hail Macbeth and Banquo!
Finally, you are the king. As the witches foretold, Thane of Glamis, Thane of Corte, and the king of Scotland. You?
Friend, tonight we hold a great banquet. I request you to be there.
Your highness has only to command. I'll surely be there, sir.
Are you riding far?
I'm going far enough that I will be riding from now until dinner. Unless my horse goes faster than expected, I'll be back an hour or two after sunset.
Don't miss our feast.
My lord, I won't be late.
You will be very late. Your next supper will be in heaven. The ride will take you to heaven itself. Banquo, my friend, you have to die. Take your son with you, or else he will be afraid of being alone here.
Your Highness, we have killed Banquo.
Let the party begin.
If Banquo too was here, it would have been a great night. All the great personalities of our nation under one roof.
Who did this?
What, my good lord?
Thou canst not say I did it. Never shake. You can't say I did it. Don't shake your bloody head at me.
Gentlemen, stand up. His highness is not well. Sit down, worthy friends. My husband is often like this, and he has been since he was a child. Please stay seated. This is just a brief fit. In a moment, he'll be well again. If you pay too much attention to him, you'll make him angry, and that will make his convulsions go on longer. Eat your dinner and pay no attention. Are you a man?
Yes, and a brave one who dares to look at something that would frighten the devil.
Oh, that's nonsense. This is just another one of the hallucinations you always get when you're afraid. This is like that floating dagger you said was leading you towards Duncan. These outbursts of yours don't even look like real fear. They are more like how you would act if you were a woman telling a scary story by the fireside in front of a grandmother. Shame on you. Why are you making these faces? When the vision passes, you will see that you're just looking at a stool.
Please, just look over there. Look, look. What do you have to say? What do I care? If you cannot, then speak to. If the dead are going to return from their graves, then there is nothing to stop the birds from eating the bodies. So, there is no point in our burying people.
What? Has your foolishness paralyzed you completely?
Go and get out of my sight. Stay in your grave. There is no matter in your bones and your blood is cold. You're staring at me with eyes that have no power to see.
Good friends, think of this as nothing more than a strange habit. It's nothing else. Too bad it's spoiling our pleasure tonight.
I am as brave as any other man. Come back to life again and challenge me to a duel in some deserted place. If I tremble then, you can call me a little girl. Get out of here, you horrible ghost, you hallucination. Get out.
You have ruined our good cheer and disrupted the gathering by making a spectacle of yourself.
Can things like this happen so suddenly without making us all astonished? You make me feel like I don't know myself. When I see you looking at these terrible things and keeping a straight face, while my face has gone white with fear.
Please, don't speak to him. He's getting worse and worse. Conversation makes him crazy. Everybody, please leave right now. Don't bother exiting in the order of your rank, but just leave right away.
Good night. I hope the king recovers soon.
A kind good night to all.
No one in the world will be able to defeat you.
But I see them. I see the ghosts. They will kill me. They are...
No man born of a natural birth can kill you, Macbeth. And unless the Burnham Forest walks to the castle, you will remain undefeated.
Yes, I am King Macbeth. The undefeated. No one can destroy my sleep. My sleepless nights are over. No one can conquer me. No one.
Fair is foul and foul is fair. Who will through the fog and filthy air?
No, you can't be here, Banco. You're dead. Go away. Or I'll thrash your head into pieces. Or am I seeing Banco's child? No. I won't allow you to become the king. I will always remain as the king of Scotland. Get away.
He will inherit the crown. My son will become the king. You will repent for your doings, Macbeth.
No. Macduff, no, I will never leave you. I have heard that you're making an army against me. Come, Macduff, I will kill you. Oh, where are you?
Thank you. There's still a spot here. Listen, she's talking. I'll write down what she says so I'll remember it better.
Come out! Damn spot! Out, I command you! One, two. Okay, it's time to do it now. Hell is murky.
Nonsense, my lord, nonsense! You're a soldier in it, you're afraid. Why should we be scared when no one can lay the guilt upon us?
But who would have thought the old man to have so much of blood in him? What? Will my hands never be clean again? No more of that, my lord. No more of that. You'll ruin everything by acting startled like this.
She says something she wouldn't have said. I'm sure of that. Heaven knows what secret she's keeping.
I still have the smell of blood on my hand. All the perfumes of Arabia couldn't make my little hand smell better.
This disease is beyond my medical skills, but I have known people who sleepwalked and weren't guilty of anything. But here, I don't know.
Out, brief candle, life's but a walking shadow. A poor player that struts and frets is upon the stage and is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. False face must hide what the false heart don't know. English are coming. Ah, let them. Yeah, they are coming. Macduff, you're going to taste my sword and I won't spare a life. I pledge I won't. The English are coming. The English are coming. Yeah, let them lie till hunger forever consumes them. We might have met them there full, face to face, and beat them backward home in England. I have almost forgot the taste of fears. Now, horror, which is familiar to my mother as thoughts, does not affect me.
It's time to end the game, Macbeth.
You were born from a woman. Swords don't frighten me. I laugh at any weapon used by a man who was born from a woman. You are the only man I have avoided, but go away now. I'm already guilty of killing your whole family.
Thou bloody villain, I have nothing to say to you. My sword will talk for me. You are too evil for words, Macbeth.
You're wasting your time trying to wound me. You might as well as try to stab the air with your sword. Go fight someone who can be harmed. I lead a charmed life, which can be ended by anyone born from a woman. Macduff?
You can forget about your charm. The evil spirit you serve can tell you that I was not born. They cut me out of my mother's womb before she could bear me naturally. Macduff was from his mother's womb, untimely ripped.
Curse you for telling me this. You have frightened away my courage. I don't believe those evil creatures anymore. They tricked me with their word games, raising my hopes and then destroying them.
I won't fight you.
Then surrender, coward, and we will put you in a freak show, just like they do with deformed animals.
I am not going to surrender and have to kiss the ground in front of Malcolm or be taunted by the common people. Even though Burnham Wood really did come to Dunsinane, and I am fighting a man not of woman born, I'll fight to the end. I'll put my shield and battle you. Come on, let's go at it, Macduff.
Here lies the man who wanted to be the king, but his over-ambitions led to his downfall. But he was a great soldier, a great warrior, the best of all. Bravo, King Macbeth, bravo.